I was the director of animal husbandry in the state of Punjab for about 19 months.
Mm-hmm.
And before that, I was director at the Central Institute for Research on Buffaloes in Hisar, mm-hmm. which is an ICR, Indian Council of Health Research Institute in Animal mm-hmm. Sciences.
Okay.
There I served as a director for 5.5 years and as principal scientist and head of the department for nearly 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
Prior to that, I was associated with the College of Veterinary Sciences at HEU Hisar as a professor, assistant professor and associate professor for almost 16 years.
Mm-hmm.
So I did my graduation in veterinary sciences and post-graduation from HEU Hisar. Then I did my PhD from University of Liverpool in UK as a Commonwealth Scholar.
Okay. That's great, sir. That brings me to my second question. So every leader has its own style of leadership. So what is your style of leadership and like how do you keep people together and how do you lead both in terms of the faculties and the students? Like how do you lead them? What is your leadership style?
My style is that we are placed in the leadership position just to deliver.
Mm-hmm.
And in order to deliver, we have to do honest efforts with to support everybody, whether it is students, our own faculty, our employees, and above all the farmers of the state.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is a veterinary university mm-hmm. where the farmers are our major stakeholders.
Mm-hmm.
So the university should develop the technologies and the solutions to the problems that are being faced by the farmers.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, we have to train our students in a very competent graduates. So that they are capable of taking all the challenges that they get in the field.
Mm-hmm.
And at the moment, we are trying to make them more of entrepreneurs rather than job seekers. They mm-hmm. should try to be more into the private practice or developing their own farms or breeding centers, whatsoever. There are mm-hmm. lots of avenues. And now the farmers also, they have to be entrepreneurs.
Mm-hmm.
So we want that the farmers as well as our graduates, they should shift towards entrepreneurship rather than seeking the government jobs.
Sure, great, sir. Sir, if you could tell us about the kind of courses which are being offered in the university and some of the flagship courses and what is the curriculum, how it benefits the students. If you could tell us something about the courses and the facilities.
The main course is Bachelor of Veterinary Science and Animal Husbandry.
Mm-hmm.
So BVSc and AH. Mm-hmm. So that is after plus two in biology. The candidates who are plus two in biology. And this year, the admission are based on the NEET marks,
mm-hmm.
scoring in the NEET.
Mm-hmm.
So we are not having a separate exam. Mm-hmm. Previously, we used to have a separate exam.
Mm-hmm.
The course is for 5 years duration, 5.5 years from now onwards.
Okay.
And for this, we have three colleges.
Mm-hmm.
One is old established College of Veterinary Sciences at Ludhiana in the main campus of the university,
mm-hmm.
Which was, I think it was in 1969 that this college was established.
Mm-hmm.
And I must tell you that this university was awarded the first position as the best agriculture university, as the best veterinary university in the country.
Okay.
And it was established, it is a young university comparatively, it was established only in 2006, so it is hardly 15 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And within these 15 years, it rose to that position.
Mm-hmm.
And the facilities here, whether for teaching, the classrooms are all digitally enabled classrooms, and we have all the infrastructure for teaching. Not only in the College of Veterinary Sciences, but also in other constituent colleges. So one college is in Ludhiana, that is the main college.
Mm-hmm.
A new college that was started last year under the university, that is at Rampura Phul in District Bathinda.
Mm-hmm.
So at both these places, and these are the university constituent colleges, there is another affiliated college at Amritsar, Khalsa Veterinary College. So all these three colleges, each has 80 seats, and all the three colleges are recognized by the Veterinary Council of India, which governs the undergraduate veterinary education in the country. And apart from that, we have the College of Fishery Sciences,
mm-hmm.
College of Biotechnology, and College of Dairy Science and Technology. So the fishery And all these colleges have undergraduate programs in which the minimum qualification is 10 plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
In DST, it is engineering. In other cities, with biology. And in addition, we have two diploma colleges as well. One of the university that is situated in district Muktasar Sahib at village Kalcharani. So there, veterinary compounders, you can say, or veterinary inspectors, or veterinary livestock development assistants. It is known by different names in different states. So that 2 years diploma after plus two, that is offered at Kalcharani in district Muktasar Sahib. And there is another course that is another college which is affiliated to the university, and it is a private college that is in village Badal. So both these colleges are offering the diploma courses. In addition, we have branches, about 17 disciplines in veterinary college, 4 disciplines in fisheries, 4 in DST, and in animal biotechnology. Then we have a school of public health and zoonosis. And that is another big strength of this university, where we have multiple international collaboration.
Sure, sir.
And even in the country, our center has been recognized as one of the lead centers for. So we have in all these subjects, plus we have PG diploma courses and certificate courses. Besides that, we also impart training to interested candidates in different aspects of animal husbandry, fishery, dairy science.
Sir, that brings me to my next question. You mentioned international tie-ups. So the one debate which is going on in Indian education system is the gap between the Indian education system and the one offered in Western countries, the developed Western countries. So there's a large gap in terms of the quality of the education between the Indian system and the one offered outside. So like, what is your viewpoint on that? How can this gap be bridged? And like, what you as the leader of the institute is trying to do to bridge this gap between Indian education system and the foreign education system? How can you bring in the best practices from there? So what is your view on that?
Bring to your information that this university has a practical international collaboration, even in UG teaching.
Mm-hmm.
Our students, they go abroad for one semester and their students come here. And what is hard is to note that the students who are coming here, they run the hands-on training, and our DBM, we also them for preparing, who are preparing for international examinations.
Mm-hmm.
And we have the maximum intake of NRI students.
Okay.
The NRI students, they are preferring the College of Veterinary Sciences at Gadwasu, Gurunga Veterinary Animal Science Universities. And we prepare them for all the students, whether they are our students or NRI students. And for that, we also have special courses that those students who want to appear for the NAVALE, National Eligibility Test for Veterinary in US and Canada, they can take up a condensed course for about 1 month or 2 months, depending on their requirement. So that is quite popular. And for overseas students who want to come here for sharpening their skills, we also have a course for them. That is, I think, 1 month. So we charge them about $1,000 for that 1 month course.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a lot of demand for that course as well.
Okay, great, sir. Now this brings me to my next question. What are some of the challenges you see in higher education, both in terms of like some generic challenges, and in the given context of COVID, it has also shaped the choices of students in terms of choosing a college. So what are the challenges you see in higher education coming up in the next 5 years?
Well, as far as choosing a stream for education is concerned, there is not much challenge because it is the choice, and this pandemic is not going to remain here. We are already conquering it, and in so many places we have already conquered it. But where we have challenge at the moment is only in the practical classes, because the clinical practice of our students, for that they have to be present themselves, because everything cannot be online. And we have allowed the students who are interested to join the clinical classes, so they can attend the clinical cases, that we have allowed. So in a class there are 80 students, if 30 students are interested, we have allowed 30 students. Apart from that, if students are interested to work at the farms to learn the management tricks, they are also welcome, and they can also. Thirdly, the students who are research students, masters and PhD students, we have also allowed them access to their laboratories so that they could complete their assignments and get the degree on time. And in the coming time, I think we have to reorient ourselves as per NEP 2020 as well, the National Education Policy 2020. Because with that, there is multiple entry and exit options. So we have to reorient our courses so that even if the student opts out after first year of his degree program, he learns at least some training, some skills. Maybe in first year, how to manage a farm. Maybe in second year, how to manage laboratories, and subsequently how to treat the animals like that. So we have to reorient our courses. But at the moment, the veterinary education, especially veterinary education, it is based on the guidelines that are received from Veterinary Council of India. But the Veterinary Council of India may not be. Is not supposed to be the main controlling agency for veterinary education as per the new education guidelines. So in that case, and the universities and colleges, they are going to have more autonomy. So in that case, we have to reorient our courses. And that will be, I think that is the silver lining, that every student who goes out of here, he has a particular set of competencies, whether it is in animal management, whether it is in laboratory diagnosis, whether it is in clinicians or in fishery also, whether they can become the entrepreneurs, or if they want to start some feed manufacturing facilities, like that, everything. In dairy science, it is the value addition that they can do. And currently, because we know that in the coming years, the farming is not going to be the business as usual. We have to invest in technology. We have to invest in infrastructure at the farm. For that also, we have started precision farming, not only in dairy farming, but also in fisheries, where everything is controlled by computer. We get the message on our mobile, and accordingly, we react to the situations.
Yes,
and here, the productivity per unit of the land is increasing, and the input cost in the long run, that will decrease. Although initial cost of the infrastructure may be more, and this is the place where we want the qualified graduates who can man this type of facilities. It is not for somebody who is a traditional farmer. It requires the knowledge and the skill and the education to handle these type of things.
Sir, I would come to my final question. I wish to know, what is your vision of the institute going ahead in next 5 years, in terms of if you want to introduce some new course or some changes in the existing curriculum? So what is your vision of the institute, say, in the next 5 years? How do you see the, where does the institute stand? What do you think about it?
I think my vision is that we should be dynamic. We should be dynamic to the needs of the society, to the needs of our stakeholders, and we should be addressing the farmers' problems in our research projects. We should be equipping our graduates as per the emerging field problems. Initially, you know that there used to be only the books written by overseas people.
Yes.
And we have now our own people coming out with books. Yesterday also I released one of the books by our faculty.
Mm-hmm.
That is that was the area so far untouched by any academician in the country, and not only academician, even the clinicians. So that was on colic in equines. So that type of, we have to develop our own strengths and our as per our situations, and that we have done. And we have the collaboration with the University of Calgary, which is amongst the top 50 universities in the world. And we also have a collaboration with the University of Saskatchewan in Canada, both in Canada. Apart from that, we have collaboration with Australia, with New Zealand, and with Europe, Germany, and in Germany also. So this is the ongoing collaboration that we have as of today. And we also have international agency sponsored, like OIE, International Institute of Animal Health, that is a UN body. We have a project twinning in veterinary education through OIE, in which Calgary University and we are collaborating in education. So that is the first of its kind course. Have projects, institutional development project, in which we are sending our faculty abroad. About 35 faculty, currently they will be sort of exposed to international laboratories. And in the recent past, about 2 years ago, we had a project that is still going on towards its fag end, in which we were sending our faculty to different labs in Canada, in USA, in Brazil, or wherever they find, just for learning that what are the skills which are under similar situations, but which we are not able to imbibe here, and which we are not here imparting here. So our faculty, and in the IDP, we also have slots for our students that they will go there. About 100 students, we have about 3 lakh rupees for each student, so that they can go in the best institutes and learn specialized trainings in wherever they have those core competencies.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir, for your time. I mean, it was great to interact with you, and we got to learn a lot about the college and the various courses being offered. And thanks a lot for your time, sir. It was great talking to you.
Thank you.